Hello, my dear friends. Today I want to share with you another way of creating smooth and nice looking areas in Paint by Numbers. Today we're going to create smooth area between 5 and E areas, and first I have to do is to paint the blue area, which is 5. And I already did some preparations. I completed the area with a light ochre color, and it's dried already. I want to tell you, you have to wait till your painting will completely dry, and after we can blur the areas we want. Let's open e-color, and now we have to create middle shade. See what I'm doing. I'm taking a little bit of e-color and put it to the cup of this container, and after I'm using the same brush, and I'm taking another shade, right, another color. I'm going to create smooth area between them. It's E and 5 mixed together now, and now I'm creating the really thick line between two areas, between E and 5. Just put this thick line everywhere, put it on top of the sharp edge, and that's it. And you have to wait, right, when this step will dry as well. Now, for better result, I will also do another layer. I will do second layer because paints of dimensions, it's transparent a little bit, so most of the time one layer it's not enough to cover the sharp line between two areas completely. Check how it's looking on your own painting. If sharp line still visible after one or two layers, that means you have to put another layer. Some shades really transparent, especially if it have yellow or red pigment inside. For example, my color number E. It has yellow pigment, and it's more transparent than the blue one. So of course I have to put a little bit more effort with this shade. And of course the best way, it's always mixing of two ways of blurring. It's overpainting technique and the middle shade technique together that I share to you right now. I really like how it's looking now, but I want to show you, to demonstrate to you, if you want to create deeper smoothing area, deeper middle color between areas. For example, sometimes it's needed, especially on backgrounds, on big areas. You have to take bigger size of brush. Now I choose the same, it's a flat synthetic brush. I will put links below this video to share to you brushes I use. And see, I'm doing basically the same. I created again the middle shade between E and 5 colors in cup of container. I'm always mixing not a big amount of middle shade, and I'm just following the edge between two areas. Brush is bigger, so of course line it's making, it's bigger also. Blending area looking deeper with more smooth gradient between two areas. So if you have to work with the small details, with the petals, or maybe it's small details on faces, on portraits, on human skin, on sometimes on sea waves. Of course, you have to create not deep, not wide area of blending. But if you have a big areas on the backgrounds, for example, on deep vases, big vase I have here in this painting with sunflowers, use bigger size of brush. It's very, very helpful. Dimension kit have only one brush inside, and it's a very small brush. So even if I like the quality of brush here, anyway, I prefer to get another brush, flat, bigger size, for better result and for work with big details. It's just more useful and fast. That's it. It's quite easy, and I hope you enjoyed it. Welcome to my channel, subscribe to me, and we will create more beautiful paintings together. It was a Painty Cat. Good luck!